Okay, can everyone hear me? Offline students? Online students, can you hear me? Okay, so today we are going to start with one more module in full stack, that is about the database. And in the database, we are going to learn about SQL and PLSQL. So today in the demo one session, we will see about what is database and why we are using database. Just some introduction about it. And later we'll start the class. Okay, now those who are joining for the first day today, like most of them are like already attending the classes, but for them who's joining newly, I'm telling just myself, Likhita. I will be here a full stack trainer here. So where we are, I will be taking all the full stack classes like core, advanced, and as well as Oracle and front end. So here today we are going to start with database. So first of all, what is a database and what is the need of database? So database is used mainly to store huge amount of data. Why we use huge amount of data we will be storing? So generally we will store the data in books or anything. If there are few people, suppose 10 or 20 students are there in a class or anywhere, we can store the information in the book, correct? If 5 students are there, I can take your attendance also in the Excel sheet and I can update the Excel sheet, no problem, correct? But if there are hundreds and thousands of students, is it possible to manually maintain it? It is difficult, right? To store the information for what course you have joined, how many classes you have attended, what is your attendance, and what is your login time, logout time. Everything, if I have to maintain manually, it is very difficult for us. So that is the reason we are choosing database. What is that? Database. Okay. So this database will be used for storing whenever we want to store huge amount of data. Okay, so how we not only just storing, we will retrieve the data, we will insert data, we will delete the data, modify the data, and update the data also. Something like if in a company is there, some employees will join, they will resign, they will move from one department to other department, or their salary incrementation will be there. Like that, you will be having so many details, right? So all the details you need to be updating. If a new employee joins, you will be storing his information. Maybe after a few days, he has given you mobile number. Joining up a mobile number, available. So he has given after a week. You have to update his database, correct? And you want to insert some data newly, or you want to delete some information. Okay, or you want to know complete details of employees who is in computers department. ఓకే కంపెనీలో కంప్యూటర్స్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ లైక్ మెకానికల్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ అట్లా డిఫరెంట్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్స్ ఉన్నాయి. సో డిపార్ట్మెంట్ వైజ్ మీకు డీటెయిల్స్ కావాలి, గ్రూపింగ్ వైజ్. సో దీస్ ఆల్ థింగ్స్ వీ కెన్ డూ ఇన్ ద డేటాబేస్. ఓకే, సో యాక్చువల్లీ యూ విల్ బి లర్నింగ్ అబౌట్ ఎస్క్యూఎల్ అండ్ పిఎల్ ఎస్క్యూఎల్. వాట్ ఈస్ దట్? ఎస్క్యూఎల్ అండ్ పిఎల్ ఎస్క్యూఎల్. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద లాంగ్వేజెస్ కామన్ టు ఆల్ డేటాబేసెస్. Common to all databases. So what database we have, like Oracle, MySQL, like Sysbase, like this we have so many databases are there, but now we are going to learn with Oracle database. Okay, so ma'am, you are teaching SQL and PLSQL with Oracle database. How if I am working tomorrow with the MySQL, will it work? ఓకే, దట్ విల్ బి డౌట్, రైట్? ఓకే, మీరు ఒరాకిల్తో టీచ్ చేస్తారు, రేపొద్దున ఒక కంపెనీకి వెళ్తే MySQL డేటాబేస్ యూజ్ చేస్తున్నారు, విల్ ఇట్ వర్క్? ఎస్. సో డేటాబేస్ అనేది డేటాను స్టోర్ రిట్రీవింగ్కి వాడతాం, బట్ ఎస్క్యూఎల్ అండ్ పిఎల్ఎస్క్యూఎల్ ఇస్ ద కామన్ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఫర్ ఎనీ డేటాబేస్. ఏ డేటాబేస్ యూజ్ చేసినా కానీ కామన్గా యూజ్ చేసే లాంగ్వేజ్ ఏంటి? ఎస్క్యూఎల్ అండ్ పిఎల్ఎస్క్యూఎల్. సో నౌ వీ విల్ బి లర్నింగ్ దిస్ so that you can work with any database. Okay, maybe slightly in few queries the syntax will be different. Okay, so now we are learn, you learn JavaScript, some know Java, some know Python language. There the representation for the numbers, maybe the data type will be there, int or something. In Oracle, the data type will be number. In MySQL, the data type will be integer. Just few differences will be there. Otherwise, everything will be same. Understood? So, like this, you will be learning this language, which will work commonly with all the databases. Understood? Online students, is it clear? Like, what is database? Database is used to store huge amount of data. Like, it will be storing huge amount of data, and in the database, not only for storing, you will also retrieve the data. Okay, and you will also insert the data, and you will delete the data, and you can also update the data. All this you can be performing. Got it? Understood? So this is about the database. So for installing this database, you can use, if you want, Oracle or MySQL, anything you install, no problem, but I will be using here Oracle. Okay, so now you can install this Oracle. Tomorrow I will tell you like how to install, how to download it, and all we will be seeing in next session, like the downloading steps and also how to install it and work with it. Okay, we will be seeing in the later session. So you can download any latest version like Oracle 21c Express Edition. Like this, you have different versions. The databases is like Oracle 9i, 8i, 9i, 10g, 11g, 12g, now 21c is also there. Still 22 is also there, but we are using like Oracle 21c Express Edition we'll be using. Okay, we will be downloading this and using it. Okay, so once you are downloading the Oracle into your laptop, it will take little time to download and install. Endukante database kada, it will store huge amount of data, so it will require some space, so it will take lot of time to download and install JDK or your whatever we downloaded Visual Studio, right? Visual Studio for our HTML and CSS. So anything, it is very simple, it requires fraction of minutes time, so you will be doing it fast. But Oracle, since it is storing very large data, it requires some space and it will take time to download and install. You should be waiting with patience. Okay, and one more thing, like when you are installing in your laptop, some laptops, if the memory is less, it will become little slow. Other all the operations that you are doing will be slow. Okay, so remove unnecessary things that you are not using, then you can download the Oracle because it will occupy some space. Okay, understood everyone? Online students, is it clear like what is database? So I think all our math students are only there. So I will be sharing every day, as you know, like how we are sharing the document and queries, everything for the database also, I will be sharing every day. So those who are new, I'm telling, like every day after the session, they will send the recording. Maybe 1-2 hours time it will take to send the recordings as well as the notes. So here in the Oracle also, same procedure will be followed. And you will also have to attend the mock interviews. I think after a month, generally we started for beginning full stack and everything. But since this is Oracle and all, you have two modules, SQL and DLSQL. After 2 weeks or 3 weeks, you will be having mock interview for the SQL. Okay, so then you can write it. You can attend mock interviews also. You can attend telephonic as well as offline. If you can come offline, it is good. You can come and give face to face. Already today some people has given. I think you know the difference, right? You might have felt little nervous since you are giving first time. Next and all, you will be having the confidence like how to answer. And whatever the interview questions that is asked in the mock interview by the other trainer, if you are not able to answer that question, make a note of it. Okay, you can search or we can discuss those interview questions in the class. Not only on HTML, CSS, now on SQL also, Already we are discussing weekly once the interview questions and all. In the same way, whatever they asked you in the mock interviews, maybe few questions you may not recollect it. So you can go through the notes and you can get back to it. But if you are not knowing at all, means that topic is not only taught in the class. Maybe if such question arrives for you in the mock interview, bring to me. Let us discuss on that. Like what is that and where we are using it and all. If we miss that topic, we can discuss on that. Okay. Like in the same way here, in the SQL also, you will be having in the same pattern, notes, everything, and you will be having the mock interviews and everything. You can follow them. Okay. So now in the database, first, before going into the SQL and PLSQL, you should know some information about DBMS. That is what? Database Management System. DBMS stands for what? Database Management System. So this is DBMS we have. So we have two things here, DBMS and RDBMS, Relational Database Management System. So these are the two things we have. So what we are doing with this DBMS or RDBMS, we are storing the data, retrieving, inserting, deleting, how we are managing our data in a proper way, that we will be learning through this. Actually, okay, we will not learn about this topic. This is completely different. DBMS, RDBMS is completely some theoretical course that is different. Now you will be learning about SQL and PLSQL only. But initially, I will give some information about it. Not only these two topics, and we will also see about normalization. What is that? Normalization. Because if you put in your resume, database, SQL, Oracle, SQL and PLSQL, they will ask you few questions, basic questions. What is DBMS? What is RDBMS? What is the difference between both of them? Like, what is normalization? Very important. Like, how many types of normalization are there? Like that, you will be having few questions on these topics. So first 2 days or 3 days, we will discuss on these topics clearly, just what is what and all. Next, we will be starting SQL, because mostly in the real-time interviews, they told me like they're asking few questions on this. Because in the database may work minimum information undali kada, what is database anedi, what is DBMS anedi, normalization anedi, veeti meeda koncham avagahana undali. So that is the reason I will be teaching some information on the those things also. So the database management, I will share this notes, just whatever I have explained now, like what are the characteristics, what is DBMS, and what are that you are going to follow. These all we will be discussing. Okay, now first of all, as I said, what is database management system and RDBMS difference? So when you are saying DBMS, database management system, it will store all the data in terms of files. We'll have like text files, Excel files, Word document files, everything in database management system. We will be storing the data in terms of, we'll talk the data will be stored in terms of what? Files. But when you're talking about RDBMS, we will store the data in terms of tables. How we will be storing tables? So now completely those who are learning full stack, wow, what is our main intention? To develop one real-time application, right? We will be developing some real-time application like Facebook or Amazon or any online library management system. Like that, you will be developing some application. Suppose here you are clicking like a Facebook login page. So when you click this, you will be getting the login page of the Facebook, where you will enter the ID and the password. So when you click the ID and password and login, where it will connect? How it is checking that it is yours only? Somewhere your data has to be stored, yes or no? మీరు మీ ఐడి పాస్వర్డ్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు మీ ఫేస్బుక్ పేజే ఓపెన్ అవుతుంది కదా, కరెక్ట్ గా ఐడి పాస్వర్డ్ మ్యాచ్ అయినప్పుడు. అంటే సమ్వేర్ యువర్ డేటా హ్యాస్ బీన్ స్టోర్డ్ వెన్ యు ఆర్ క్రియేటింగ్, కరెక్ట్? అండ్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ క్రియేటింగ్ ఎ న్యూ యూజర్ సైన్ అప్ ఫర్ ద ఫేస్బుక్, ఐ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ అకౌంట్, దెన్ వాట్ యు విల్ డూ, యూ విల్ క్లిక్ ఆన్ సైన్ అప్ పేజ్. సో హియర్ యూ విల్ బి గివింగ్ ఆల్ ద డీటెయిల్స్, కరెక్ట్? యువర్ ఫస్ట్ నేమ్, లాస్ట్ నేమ్ అండ్ మొబైల్ నెంబర్, పాస్వర్డ్, డేట్ ఆఫ్ బర్త్ and everything you'll give, and you will give on sign up. So when you are doing this, all the details that you are giving here are stored in what? Database. Stored in where? Database. How they are storing, what format they are storing in? Tabular format, like as a table. So when the data is stored in terms of table, we will be calling it as a RDBMS, relational database management system. All the data will be stored in terms of table, because we should have relationship between each and every table that is created. See, now you are creating one table for this, where you will be storing all this information, correct? And you need one more table for storing the login and password or other details. Okay, so like that you will be having interconnection between each and every table. So how we will establish the connection and all, we will see through the SQL queries. Means there should be some common columns where there is some constraints, everything, where we are linking from one table to another table, like that. So we will be storing data in the database in terms of what? Table, tabular formula data ni manam store chestam. Is it clear? So how we are storing? In terms of table. So now, after completing core and advanced Java, like you have learnt already, meeri front page create cheyagalaru kada ippudu with the html and css knowledge, can you create it? Yes. So now you will be learning JavaScript also for validation. Ikka nenu sign up ante, is it moving to next page? No, it is giving an error, like some fields are mandatory, you have to enter. So ee validation manam ippudu nechukone JavaScript dwara nechukuntam. Okay, that whatever JavaScript. And after that, completely core and advanced, when you learn, you will be able to develop some real-time application like this. And when you are giving on sign up, then it will store in the database. And next time when you log in, you will be giving your ID and your password. So when you give your ID and password and click the login, it will match. Okay, some table is created. మీ న్యూ యూజర్ క్లిక్ చేసినప్పుడు ఒక టేబుల్లో మీ ఐడి పాస్వర్డ్ సేవ్ అయి ఉంటాయి. ఆ ఐడి పాస్వర్డ్తో మ్యాచ్ అవుతుందా లేదా అని డేటాబేస్లో ఆ టేబుల్లో చెక్ చేస్తుంది. చెక్ చేసి వెన్ ఇట్ మ్యాచెస్, ఇట్ విల్ ఓపెన్ యువర్ పేజ్. అదర్వైజ్ ఇట్ విల్ సే లైక్ అథెంటికేషన్ ఎర్రర్, పాస్వర్డ్ రాంగ్ ఆర్ ఐడి ఈజ్ రాంగ్, లైక్ దట్ ఇట్ విల్ గివ్ యూ అన్ ఎర్రర్. ఓకే, సో ఫర్ దీస్ ఆల్ పర్పసెస్ వీ నీడ్ ద డేటాబేస్. And we need some properties to store. Some conditions will be there, some constraints will be there. Something like names will be repeated, correct? Two or three people can have same name, but user ID will be unique. When you join for the institute for the course, after enrollment, everyone will be given ID, right? So the ID will be what? Unique. ID should not be duplicate. And not null values. Every person will have a name. Can we give null value? Okay, they can tell address tomorrow, mobile number tomorrow, like email address after few days, but name they have to mandatory tell you. So though there will be some columns where you have to give like compulsory the information, mandatory, like name or anything. So while we are storing data in the database, we can use, put those conditions. The user ID cannot be null value. The user ID cannot be duplicate value. Like that, we can put some conditions. And when you are entering the gender can should be either male or female. Like that, you can put some constraints. Constraints are called conditions. You can put and you can store the data into the table. These all things we will be doing in the database. Understood? So we will be creating, and as I said, in DBMS we will store data in terms of what? File. And in RDBMS we will be storing data in terms of tabular format. And as I said, here you will be having constraints. What is that? Primary key. So primary key means it is a combination of both not null and duplicate. Ante meeru oka id, oka person id store chestunaru, id ki primary key ani ichar ankonde, dan artham enti? Id cannot be null value and id cannot be duplicate. Rendu kavalsinappudu manam em use chestam? Primary key. So manaki separate ga not null unique kuda ivvachu. But when you want both to be applied for any column, then what you will be using? Primary key. So whenever you are giving for any column primary key, that means what? The data cannot be null and the data cannot be duplicate. Okay, so this is one more difference. Okay, but there is nothing like that in the DBMS format. It you can give in any file storage as a hierarchical structure or anything. And next, one more important concept, normalization. What is that? Normalization we have. Later we will see like step by step the types of normal forms also. First, second, third, like that we have different normal forms. Boycott normal form, fifth normal form, like that. Ante detail ga manam emi chudam, just what is what anedi discuss chestam ante. And now here the normalization is not present with the database management. In RDBMS we have normalization. So now what is this normalization means? Normalization ante enti? Normalization ante removing the anomalies, means that the issues. When you are creating table, there will be some problem, like as I said, primary key tho undadu, duplicate values kuda accept chestundi. Okay, like that we have so many constraints we will be getting. So by normalization we will remove those constraints, those problems, and we will make a perfect table without any issues. So those concept is present in the RDBMS, that is normalization concept. And DBMS is not providing you any security. There is no security regarding data manipulation. But in RDBMS we have the so many constraints are there where it will provide some security with the ACID properties. Okay, we will discuss what are ACID properties. ACID properties means atomicity, consistency, isolation and durability. So these all things we will be discussing. Okay, so these all properties are maintained in the RDBMS. Okay, so as I said, it will be tabular format. So DBMS means small data. Here you can handle large amount of data with multiple users. So many users can be created and they can be used. So like as I said, DBMS example are any files, XML or any files will be there. Example of RDBMS is like Oracle is the database, MySQL, PostgreSQL, SQL Server. Like this you have different databases. So these are examples of the RDBMS and DBMS. Is it clear? DBMS and RDBMS difference. Online students, is it clear everyone? The difference between DBMS and RDBMS. So everyone, can you please reply? Am I audible? Okay, any doubts regarding topics till now that we have discussed? Emana doubts unnaya andi? So as you are learning SQL and PLSQL now, if there is any opportunity that you are getting for SQL and PLSQL, sometimes you will get job opportunity for SQL developer or Oracle developer. Those opportunities also we will provide you. Like as soon as it opportunity comes, then we will ask you to share the resume and you can. So for that, you have to be always ready by attending this mock interviews, everything. They will see the score and how many interviews you have attended, and they will give you the chance. And who get less score also, they will be attending. But we will see on what basis, where you are lagging in, maybe technically or maybe in the communication or aptitude. Already who is enrolling for the full stack, they're using the facility of aptitude and other classes, communication classes also, right? So definitely you will have a good opportunity when you are entering, because many companies, they were telling like they're technically good, but they're not able to communicate properly. That is the main problem. Communication means not just speaking in English, right? You also have to put your answers in a proper way, as I think they're telling you every day in classes. Okay, so those who are attending like only SQL classes, you can also just learn everything if you are interested, and you can learn this communication and aptitude classes also. So now I will be explaining about this atomic properties, like what is atomicity, acid properties, what is atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. We'll discuss about these things. First, let us discuss about this atomicity property in the RDBMS. So why we are using this and what is the use of this property? So here, what do you mean by atomic or atomicity property has to be followed? Suppose you are performing some transaction from one account to another account. So you can see the picture here for your clarity. So this A has the, like before it has some 30 as it's the money. And debit has to be what? How much? 10. And what is the available? 20. So here sometimes when you go for the ATM, and withdraw the money, you will not get the money, but you will get a message like your money got detected, and after few days you will get back the money like that. So like not he being atomic city means what? Without deducting, without you getting the money, the database is getting updated that money has been withdrawn. So that should not happen. Okay, so the transaction can be told like it is complete when all the tasks are being completed on a particular task. And indulo unna complete task enti, what is your amount in the beginning, how much you are debiting, what is the balance. After transferring or withdrawing, then you have to get the remaining balance. Anni transactions ayin tarvata maatrame updation message raavali. Proper. It should allow all the transactions to be completed. Either it should do all or it should do zero. Ante emi transaction jaragakoddu ledha complete ga anni steps follow up. So then we will tell that it is atomicity has been followed. Or you can tell no atomicity or partial execution is there, or you can say the execution has been terminated if it is not done properly. So here like this, if it is before 30, debit 10 and available 20, yes it is correct. But here if you are seeing, when you are saying before it is 100, so when here it is debiting, here it has to what? Credit 10. What should be the available balance? So A lo 30 undi, debit 10 ayindi, available ent undi? 20 undi. B ki transfer chesinappudu before crediting ఎంత ఉంది 100, ఆఫ్టర్ క్రెడిటింగ్ 10 ఎంత అవ్వాలి? 110 అవ్వాలి. కానీ అయిందా? అవ్వలేదు. సో మీన్స్ వాట్? సమ్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ ఫెయిల్డ్, సో దిస్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఫాలోయింగ్ ద అటామిసిటీ రూల్ అని అర్థం అనమాట. ఓకే, సో దిస్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ గెటింగ్, ఇఫ్ యూ కెన్ టెల్ ద అటామిసిటీ హ్యాస్ బీన్ ఫాలోడ్, దెన్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి లైక్ దిస్, ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్లీ క్రెడిటెడ్ బిఫోర్ 30, ఆఫ్టర్ డెబిటింగ్ 10, ద అవైలబుల్ అమౌంట్ ఈస్ వాట్? 20. హియర్ ఆల్సో బిఫోర్ ఇన్ ద బి అకౌంట్ ఇనిషియల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ 100, ఆఫ్టర్ క్రెడిటింగ్ 10, వాట్ ఈస్ ద అవైలబుల్ అమౌంట్? 110. దెన్ యూ కెన్ టెల్ లైక్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫాలోయింగ్ ద అటామిసిటీ రూల్. అటామిసిటీ రూల్ అంటే ఏంటి? ఒక కంప్లీట్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ జరగటానికి మనకి 10 స్టెప్స్ ఉన్నాయి, లేదా 5 స్టెప్స్ ఉన్నాయి. అన్ని స్టెప్స్ ప్రాపర్ గా జరగాలి. సగం జరిగి సగం స్టెప్స్ ఫెయిల్ అయిపోతే దెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ఫాలోయింగ్ ద యాసిడ్ రూల్. ఏ పాయింట్ ఏ ఫస్ట్ ఏ రూల్ ఇస్ ఫెయిల్డ్. ఓకే, సో లైక్ దట్. నౌ ఆర్డిబిఎంఎస్ విల్ ఫాలో ఆల్ దీస్ రూల్స్. ఏ రూల్ విల్ బి ఫాలోడ్? బట్ ఇన్ డిబిఎంఎస్, ఇన్ సింపుల్ ఫైల్స్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్ఎంఎల్ ఫార్మాట్, వీ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ సచ్ రూల్ ప్రాపర్టీ ఫాలోడ్. ఓకే, సో దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ రూల్. ఈజ్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ ఎవ్రీ వన్? అటామిసిటీ రూల్ అర్థమైందా అండి అందరికి? ఈజ్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ ఎవ్రీ వన్? ఆన్లైన్ స్టూడెంట్స్, కెన్ యూ ప్లీజ్ రిప్లై దట్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ అబౌట్ ద అటామిసిటీ ప్రాపర్టీ? Okay, so once again I'll explain about the atomicity property. One, see here. So I thought, okay, picture I'll give so that you will understand clearly. So there are 4 properties: atomicity, consistency, and isolation and durability. These are the 4 properties our RDBMS is following. They may ask you, what are the acid properties? Can you explain them? So first property is what? Atomicity. In the atomicity property means what? When all the transactions are done, either it should do all the transactions or it should not do anything. That is what is called atomicity. To complete any task, you need some steps. Ante manam suppose adding 2 numbers or adding 3 numbers unnai anukundam, what are the steps you will follow? You will declare variables, initialize the data, add 2 numbers, and then finally you will print. Ivanni step by step. So adding numbers ane task eppudu complete avutundi? Anni steps correct ga chesinappudu. Initialize cheyakunda add cheyagalama? Ledu. Initialize chesi add cheyipothe task complete ayinatta? Ledu. So in atomicity we should not do half half. Either you should do completely or you should not do anything. So that is what is called atomicity means. Okay, that is what given in the definition also. You can go through it. Like if any operation is performed on the data, either it should be performed or executed completely, or it should not be executed at all. Endukante asal emi start cheyipothe fresh ga malli without mistakes you can do it, but sagam chesi tappu, it should not be as a mistake, and in between there should not be any break, okay, while executing. So now here, what we are doing? We are sending money from one account to another account. So now what are the steps that are you have to compulsory follow? What is the balance in your account? How much you are transferring? And what is your balance after transferring? Okay, meer mee friend ki money transfer chestunaro. Maybe you got 30, you are transferring 10. After transferring, it got updated in your account 20. But he is telling I did not receive it. That means what? It is not following the rule properly. Atomicity is not properly followed. So when you tell that it is properly followed, once it is deducted from your account, the other person account also has to be credited. then you can tell that transaction is success. Transaction is success. So like this, when all the steps are followed, then you can tell that it is following the atomicity rule perfectly. Adhamainandi? So online student, is it clear about the atomicity property? Sandeep, adhamainandi? Okay, yes. And the next property we have as consistency. This is all the properties will have some or the other similar only. So here in the consistency property, like whatever the changes you have made on transaction should be always consistent, same. Okay, and for some transaction you will follow one rule, for other transaction you will follow another rule. It should not be there. For all the transactions you are doing, the data should be consistently maintained, correctly maintained before and after the transaction. That whatever the data you are maintaining should be consistent, means properly before and after the transaction also the updations have to be proper. Then we tell it is following the consistency property. Like before you are having, just observe this. This is one account, like where you are having the transaction started from A. So how much is the amount? 300. How much you are debiting to the B? 50. And what will be the available? 250. At the same time, you are debiting to the C also how much? 20. So what is the amount? 230. Okay. So here you can see. So before it is 100, after crediting 50, what is the value? 150. And before it is 50 and after crediting 20, how much it is? 70. Okay, that means what? The data is consistently updated in all the accounts that you are, multiple accounts also you are transferring. Here when you are debiting, like adding 150, and here it is not updated properly. From both the accounts it is deducting the money, right? From here it is deducting for both the accounts. 300 lo inchi 50 for B account, then we got 250. Again 20 you are deducting to C account. Okay, so both the transactions chesinappudu kuda manaki proper ga consistent ga value anedi undal. Ante enti ikkada 300 nunchi 250 ki update aina tarvate money deduct avvali. Okay, so meeru first B class B account ki money pampicharu, 50 amount pampicharu. Pampichin tarvata 250 anedi update avvali. Update avvakunda 300 ni teeskoni ganaka manam transaction chesthe adi consistent ga unnattu kaadu. Okay, ardhamainda? So meeru two transactions at a time chestunnaru, okaliki 50 rupees okaliki 100 rupees. So mee account lo inchi 50 deduct ayi, mee account lo 50 డిడక్ట్ అయ్యాక 250 అని అప్డేట్ అయిన తర్వాతే సెకండ్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ స్టార్ట్ అవ్వాలి. అలా కాకుండా 300 ని బేస్ గా తీసుకొని రెండు అకౌంట్స్ కి ఒకసారే పంపకూడదు. సో అలాంటప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది, ఫస్ట్ అకౌంట్ కి 50 పంపారు, సెకండ్ అకౌంట్ కి 20 నే పంపుతున్నారు కాబట్టి ఇట్స్ ఓకే ఫైన్, రిమైనింగ్ 250 నుంచి 20 తగ్గుతుంది. లేదా సెకండ్ అకౌంట్ కి మీరు 270 అట్లా పంపిస్తున్నారు అనుకోండి, ఏమవుతుంది, అప్డేట్ అవ్వకపోతే రెండింటికి 300 బ్యాలెన్స్ గా తీసుకొని 50 260 పంపించడం కుదురుతుందా? అవ్వదు కదా. బట్ మనీ డిడక్ట్ అయ్యి మీ అకౌంట్ నెగిటివ్ లోకి వెళ్ళింది అనుకోండి, దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ కన్సిస్టెంట్ అనమాట. ఓకే, వెన్ యు ఆర్ సెండింగ్ మనీ ఫర్ టూ అకౌంట్స్ ఎట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్, ఫస్ట్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ జరిగి అప్డేట్ అయిన తర్వాతే సెకండ్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ అనేది స్టార్ట్ అవ్వాలి. ఓకే, దెన్ వీ విల్ టెల్ ద ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్ ఆర్ వాట్ కన్సిస్టెంట్. Transactions are what? Consistent. Understood? So that is the meaning. Is it clear, everyone, online students, about the consistency? Offline students, ardhamainandi? Meeku ardhamainandi? So here, before reading the value only, it has to be updating with 250. If it is not updating with 250, then we will tell that it is not consistent. Adhamaindi kada? So like that. So isolation is also similar when you are performing two transactions at the same time. So the second transaction has to be wait till the first transaction has to be completed. First transaction complete aina tarvate second transaction anedi start avvali. So similar example we will be giving here also. So like for the isolation also. So you can take the example like when you are deducting money for both the accounts at the same time. T1, T2 transactions are done at the same time. For T1 the value is 100 for before deducting. For T2 the value will be what? 80. Okay, rendu transactions okasare jaragakoddu, one after the other matrame jaragali. So that is also like similar to the consistency. So next one is like durability. So what is this durability means? Manam ikka database lo whenever you are performing some transactions in the database, always we have to save the transaction. Maybe in Oracle or MySQL or anything. Sometimes what the transactions that you have done might not be saved. మనం చేసిన టేబుల్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తాం, ఇన్సర్ట్ చేస్తాం, వాల్యూస్ అన్ని మోడిఫై చేస్తాం. ఇఫ్ సడన్లీ దెర్ ఈస్ సమ్ నెట్వర్క్ ఇష్యూ ఆర్ ఎనీ పవర్ ఇష్యూ హ్యాస్ బీన్ కమ్, వాట్ ఎవర్ డేటా యూ హ్యావ్ డన్ టిల్ దట్ టైమ్ మైట్ నాట్ బి సేవ్డ్, బట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి సేవ్డ్ ప్రాపర్లీ బై యూజింగ్ ఏ ఆప్షన్ కాల్డ్ కమిట్. కమిట్ ఎందుకు యూజ్ చేస్తాం మనం? ఫర్ సేవింగ్ ద ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్. అంటే మనం డేటాని స్టోర్ చేసినా, రిట్రీవ్ చేసినా, లేదా కొత్త డీటెయిల్స్ ఎంటర్ చేసిన, అప్డేట్ చేసిన, ఓకే, అన్ని డేటా ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్ కూడా ప్రాపర్గా సేవ్ అయి ఉండాలి. ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి కమిటెడ్ ప్రాపర్లీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ డ్యూరబిలిటీ. ద ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్ హ్యావ్ టు బి సేవ్డ్ ప్రాపర్లీ. గాట్ ఇట్? సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఫోర్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ వీ హ్యావ్ యాసిడ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్: అటామిసిటీ, కన్సిస్టెన్సీ, ఐసోలేషన్ అండ్ డ్యూరబిలిటీ. Understood everyone? Online students, is it clear? So atomicity means what? In atomicity, like if you are doing a set of transactions to complete the task, either you have to do all or do nothing. That is atomicity. And consistency means what? Data should be properly maintained before and after the transaction. Isolation: when you are performing two or three transactions on same data, T1 is one transaction, T2, T3. After completing T1 only, T2 has to be starting the transaction. It has to wait. Step by step it has to perform. Durability means proper saving of the transactions has to be done. Okay, these are the four ACID properties you have in the RDBMS. Got it? Understood? So theoretically one day or tomorrow also you will be learning about some information. After that SQL, PLSQL means everything will be in query. Theoretical chala takku untundi, pratidi kuda practical knowledge e untundi. Okay, like queries write, execute cheyatam. ఓకే, లైక్ ఫర్ క్రియేటింగ్, ఇన్సర్టింగ్, డిలీటింగ్ మన క్వరీ రాస్తాం, డేటాబేస్లో చెక్ చేస్తాం అంతే. సో అందుకని ప్రాక్టికల్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఎక్కువ అవసరం అవుతుంది. ప్రాక్టీసే కావాలి ఎక్కువగా దీనికి. ఇంపార్టెంట్, మీకు ఎస్క్యూఎల్ అర్థం అవ్వాలి అంటే ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయాలి. సో చెప్పినప్పుడు విన్నప్పుడు బాగుంటుంది, ఓకే, ఇంత సింపుల్గా ఉంటుంది, కానీ ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయకపోతే ఏమీ గుర్తుండదు, అర్థం కాదు, ఓకేనా? సో మీరు దీనికోసం ఫస్ట్ ఒరాకిల్ డేటాబేస్ అనేది ఇన్స్టాల్ చేయాలి. ఇన్స్టాల్ చేసి ప్రాపర్గా వర్క్ అయ్యేలా చూడాలి. సో ఇన్స్టాలేషన్లో కొంతమంది ప్రాబ్లం ఫేస్ చేస్తారు. ఒకటి, మెమరీ సరిపోకపోవటం డేటాబేస్ ల్యాప్టాప్ ఆర్ యువర్ పీసీ. ఇంకొకటి ఏంటంటే, వైల్ ఇన్స్టాలింగ్ ఇఫ్ దెర్ ఈస్ ఎనీ అదర్, కొంతమందికి ఆల్రెడీ వేరే డేటాబేస్ మైఎస్క్యూఎల్ కానీ ఇంకేదన్నా పోస్ట్ గ్రీఎస్క్యూఎల్ కానీ ఏదన్నా ఆల్రెడీ ఉన్న ఫైల్ని మీరు డిలీట్ చేసినా ఇంప్రాపర్గా డిలీట్ అయిందనుకోండి, ఇది ఇన్స్టాల్ అవ్వదు. సో డిలీట్ ఎప్పుడైనా ఒక సాఫ్ట్వేర్ డిలీట్ చేయాలంటే డైరెక్ట్ డిలీట్ చేయకండి. కంట్రోల్ ప్యానెల్లోకి వెళ్ళి అన్ఇన్స్టాల్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ అని మాత్రమే అన్ఇన్స్టాల్ చేయండి. మీరు డైరెక్ట్గా డిలీట్ చేస్తే డేటా డిలీట్ అవ్వదు. సో కొన్ని డిలీట్ అయ్యి కొన్ని అవ్వవు. ఎందుకంటే చాలా మంది స్టూడెంట్స్ లో చూసాను కాబట్టి చెప్తున్నాను. అప్పుడు మళ్ళీ వెతికి అవి అన్ఇన్స్టాల్ చేసి అప్పుడు ప్రాపర్ గా ఇన్స్టాల్ చేశాను మొన్న ఒకరికి, అందుకని చెప్తున్నాను. అండ్ ఫర్ సమ్ పీపుల్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద పర్మిషన్ ఇష్యూస్ ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ సేవ్ ఇన్ ద ఫోల్డర్ ప్రాపర్లీ, అప్పుడు మనం రోల్ బ్యాక్ అయిపోతుంది మీరు ఇన్స్టాల్ చేసే అంటే. మీకు పాసిబుల్ కేసెస్ చెప్తున్నాను. వెన్ యూఆర్ ఇన్స్టాలింగ్ ఇట్ విల్ ఇన్స్టాల్ హాఫ్ అండ్ ఇట్ విల్ రోల్ బ్యాక్, అంటే ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ అన్డు అంటాం కదా మనం వర్డ్ డాక్యుమెంట్ లో, అంటే ప్రీవియస్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ క్యాన్సిల్ చేస్తాం అట్లా రోల్ బ్యాక్ అవ్వే ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది. సో అలాంటప్పుడు మనం జస్ట్ సేవ్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఫోల్డర్ మారిస్తే సరిపోతుంది. ఓకే, సో దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ద థింగ్స్ దట్ యు మైట్ ఫేస్ వైల్ యు ఆర్ ఇన్స్టాలింగ్ ఒరాకిల్ డేటాబేస్. ఓకే, సో ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ సెషన్ వీ విల్ డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ఫ్యూ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ఆన్ డిబిఎంఎస్ అండ్ వీ విల్ సీ అబౌట్ నార్మలైజేషన్ అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వీ విల్ స్టార్ట్ ఎస్క్యూఎల్ అండ్ పిఎల్ఎస్క్యూఎల్. ఓకే, గాట్ ఇట్, అండర్స్టూడ్, అర్థమైందండి? ఆన్లైన్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఎవ్రీ వన్, ఏమైనా డౌట్స్ ఉన్నాయా ఇవాళ సెషన్లో? అంటే బేసిక్ జస్ట్ వాట్ ఈస్ డేటాబేస్ అనేది చెప్పాను, ఎందుకంటే ఇవంతా క్లారిటీ లేకుండా డైరెక్ట్ ఎస్క్యూఎల్ వర్క్ చేస్తే మీకు ఇంటర్వ్యూకి హెల్ప్ అవ్వదు, అసలు డేటాబేస్ అంటే ఏంటో కూడా అర్థం కాదు. ఓకే, ఆన్లైన్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఏమైనా డౌట్ ఉన్నాయా అండి? దోస్ హు ఆర్ అటెండింగ్ న్యూలీ, ఇఫ్ దే ఆర్ అటెండింగ్ ఎనీ వన్, ప్లీజ్ సెండ్ ఎ మెసేజ్ టు ద అడ్మిన్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ దట్ యు ఆర్ అటెండింగ్ డెమో వన్. ఐ థింక్ ఆన్లైన్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ ఆర్ అటెండ్ ఆర్ ద ప్రీవియస్ వన్ ఓన్లీ ఐ థింక్ యు ఆర్ దేర్ అండ్ హూ ఈస్ అటెండింగ్ న్యూలీ ప్లీజ్ సెండ్ ఏ మెసేజ్. ఓకే, ఎస్, ఓకే, దెన్ వీల్ కంటిన్యూ టుమారో సెషన్. ఓకే, మీకు ఏమైనా డౌట్స్ ఉన్నాయా అండి? అర్థమైందా? సో థియరీ ఎక్కువ ఉండదు, సో మ్యామ్ ఇదంతా వినాలా అనుకోవద్దు. 1 డే, మేబీ 1-2 డేస్ ఉంటుంది, ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ క్వరీస్ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ గా ఉంటుంది. కాన్సెప్ట్ మీకు ప్రాక్టికల్ నాలెడ్జ్ లైక్ హెచ్టిఎంఎల్ సిఎస్ఎస్ ఎలా మోర్ ప్రాక్టికల్ చేశారో అలాగే ప్రాక్టీస్ సెషన్సే ఉంటాయి మ్యాక్సిమం. ఓకే.